Hour two of Epileptic Gaming's Faces for Radio is upon us. And I'm happy to announce our first contest here on Faces for Radio. If you can guess the number of pretzels in this, Summa will give you a hand job. So start submitting your guesses to Epileptic Gaming on Stick'Em. I understand that Cammy's already counted the number of pretzels in here. And Summa will give you a hand job. What's up?
Or a little job like DJ two times. Like that.
Hour two here for Faces for Radio number 8. I wrote down a few topics to discuss today, Summa.
Fat Baby says 519.
519?
Yeah. Mac 19 says 420.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, don't tell me all the fucking answers, because then other people are going to take it. Nintendo's holiday blockbuster, Summa. Question part one.
Wii
do
music.
You care?
Don't care.
Question part two, then what do you think it could be?
Wii Music.
Wii Music?
Yep.
You don't think it's possibly Kid Icarus?
Who cares if it is?
Because Kid Icarus was one of the best fucking 8-bit games
back
ever.
Back in the day. Yeah, it was awesome.
No, you didn't even play it, did you?
Who cares? Yeah.
Did you play it?
Yes, I played it.
I think that's fucking bullshit.
You can call it
all right.
Fucking nostalgia fags on
the internet. Hold on.
We'll say this shit like it's fucking going to sell gold and it'll sell, you know what? It'll sell a million copies in like 3 months.
What three items did you need to face the final boss? That you didn't play
it. 20 years ago. Who gives a fuck?
What do you mean?
I'm playing Call of Duty 4. I'm playing, you know, whatever else is out now.
I give a fuck.
A shit about Kid Icarus. Does some 19-year-old playing Halo 3 give a shit about Kid Icarus?
They fucking should, because Halo 3 wouldn't fucking exist if games like Kid Icarus didn't come out.
So what?
Okay.
Does that mean I have to Does that mean I have to like Jerry Lee Lewis or like Elvis Presley or whoever else because they were the precursor of rock nowadays? No. I mean, come on. That's a retarded argument.
It's not retarded.
Yeah, it is.
It's not retarded. I bet you. Well, okay. So as a fan of music, maybe not. But don't you think that a true music enthusiast, don't you think that someone who's in the music industry.
I can appreciate Kid Icarus. I can appreciate what came before it. But am I going to like it now? Am I excited for a new one?
I didn't ask you to fucking like it. I asked you what three items you needed to defeat the final fucking boss in the game.
I need a tampon.
Nope.
An anti-gay.
Nope.
Do you even know who you fought at the end of the game? I was 8 years old. I can't remember yesterday.
Do you even know?
I can't remember what happened yesterday.
I'm not going to remember what happened 20 years ago of a game that I played maybe two times in my entire life. Audience, this is a great example of how you earn DJ Wheat's respect, okay? You can earn DJ Wheat's respect very easily by saying, DJ Wheat, that's actually a simple question to answer. All you need is the map, the pencil, and the sacred words so that you can
fight. That sounds awesome. The map and the pencil. Sacred words.
And
sign
then
me up.
The mirror shield.
Like an awesome video game.
And you fight Medusa, and there you go. Fucking worthless. I swear to God. Call in the show, 866-408-4445. All right, how about this?
Now, if you asked, was Bo Jackson the best Super Tecmo Bowl player ever? Yes.
Oh, God. All right, how about this? It's been reported, Summa, that Little Big Planet has gone alpha, and that means that a lot of people are happy about, because I don't know if you guys remember this, but they claimed that the demo would actually be open beta. So now that they've gone into alpha, there is exactly 164 days before this game is supposed to be released. So between in the next 164 days, you will be able to play Little Big Planet.
I'm excited for that.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Yeah. That is kind of cool.
I cannot wait till that game comes out. I can't wait to see what EG people do with that game. Like Mally, like someone like Mally. I can't wait to see what people like Mally and Fishstick do with that game.
I bet people are going to make giant penises and
lots of penises and vaginas.
It's going to be
lots of tentacle porn.
Lots. Lots of Yuri. Lots of Yuri.
That's a two girls, one cup.
One other thing, Summa.
Yes.
And you QQ'd about this a little bit yesterday. Eye of Judgment set to expansion number 2.
Just as I became dominant.
200 new cards.
Oh, man.
200 new cards you're going to have to deal with. And Summa was fucking QQing like crazy. Like crazy. Hold that thought, though. We've got our next caller. We've got Steve on the line. Steve, what's up?
What's QQ?
Hey, how's it going?
It's going well.
Well. First of all, I want to comment on
first
your
first of
shirt.
All, stop shouting.
The cake is a lie shirt. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, the cake is a lie shirt.
The cake is a lie.
Oh, you should let everybody see that. I'm a big fan of Portal.
Wait, are you talking about the guy over here?
Yeah. I'm talking about you, DJ.
That's actually a fucking Atari 2600 controller.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Although I wish it was a cake was a lie shirt. But I can actually see how you would mistake it.
Yeah, I have one of those. I got it from Jinx. Anyways, I wanted
to say, look at my Mario 64 shirt, buddy.
Don't listen to
Mario
Summa. He's a dick.
Right there.
What? Fucking, the hell's that game called?
What? Goldeneye?
American Idol?
Oh, he ended the call.
Oh.
Or he got cut off. Dude, I was like...
EG Knights did
it was
like
on the
guy.
Tip of his fucking tongue, dude. Steve, call back. And
please, your gaming knowledge is something
it's better
require.
Than yours.
Oh, yeah, because I first thing when I saw that shirt, Portal. Cake.
Yeah, but you're watching on an NTSC quality over there. He's watching in like a stick of window this big. And yeah, so you can reach the show 866-408-4445. 200 new cards, Summa.
I know. I have to remember 200 new cards now.
Yeah. Do you think your brain can handle it?
Yes, of course. It's going to suck. I mean, it took like, you know, who knows how long until now to the point where I feel pretty dominant. Beat the 86 ranked guy in the world. Beat everyone I go against now. You know, I feel pretty confident with my deck. And then in 2 weeks or March 24th. Whenever, there's going to be 200 new cards out there. Like,
that's right. That's right, 200 new cards.
I just learned the ones that are out now.
And we got a new caller on the horn. We got Brian. Brian, what's up?
Yeah, see, well, don't you like how you were like owning people in the game? The next thing you know, bring out the fucking expansion. I didn't fucking just like, you got to be sucky at the beginning. Do you like that?
Wow.
And then you have to learn the cards.
Are you, like, masturbating while you're saying this, or...?
I was trying to think. I'm like too hyper.
You know, I'll still own them. It just sucks because you have to. The only way to learn about these cards if you don't have them is playing someone against them.
Right.
And of course, is losing against them or making a mistake. So it's just gonna suck for like a little while. But
yeah, but you know what? Think
it.
About
it,
dude. Like, not everyone. I mean,
yeah, not
with the exception of like four or five mutants, you got to think it's gonna be a while. You may see one or two new cards a match.
That'll be cool.
And I'm
it'll
sure
be
there'll be a lot of commons.
It's just, you know, learning 200 new cards.
Yeah, but I was saying to this, and I was. And Brian, tell me if you agree with this. You know, the cool thing about it is that you've been playing with 200 cards for the past, 6 months now? Like, isn't it cool to think that, oh, my God, this is becoming a whole new game to me, because you're going to have 200 cards?
I'm not going
to
lie. I think it's
exciting. Yeah, I think it's good that you play a game so long or whatever, and then it's like, starting to get used to cards, and you're like, I want more. I want to do more out of it. Because it's like, with me, it's like I've played like the old Yu-Gi-Oh card game stuff and like Magic the Gathering. It's like, started with Yu-Gi-Oh, and then I was like, man, I want to do more. And then I started playing like Magic, and I'm like, you can do more. I like it. It's more faster paced. There's so much more you can do with the cards. And,
you know, the only thing,
it
honestly,
opens up the strategy is
you know
what
you're
saying,
I would like
Ryan,
to see happen? You know, you know what I would like to see happen in Eye of Judgment? I would love for them to have
a win button.
No, a server or a ranked match option completely separate from the original game where you can pick any card in your deck, where it's not a random draw. I want to get to that point where you can actually build your deck upon like how you want to play rather than having to depend on a random draw. Not saying random is bad and I don't like how it's played right now, but you know, when I was building my deck in a certain way, you know, it would be nice to have a deck where I could just pick whenever I want.
You know, a couple of the new cards, though.
Yeah, but as my deck is now, it's built because of the random. It's built because of the random draw, where no matter what I draw, I'm pretty much safe.
Yeah, but now some of the new cards let you go through your deck and pull out the cards you want.
That's true.
So, you know, I mean, and they're going to have to balance that, but...
I don't know. I love Eye of Judgment, guys. I mean, everyone knows that. I think it's the hotness.
But Seymour, what you're saying that you actually, your deck's actually built based upon randomness. So you're saying you kind of want, like, say, Magic the Gathering or something where you actually get to physically build the deck.
I just would like the option. I would like the option where you can actually draw from your deck and you don't have to rely on a random draw. That's
would be
all.
Shit.
Just that option. I'm not saying change the whole game, but just that little option of maybe if they're unranked games or whatever.
You know,
it would be cool to play that way.
Brian, since Summa can't seem to like get the words out of his head, I think what he's trying to say let me comment for a second, Summa, because you actually told me one time we were talking about like mana cost for monsters.
Right.
And you told me that you
this
had
is
basically
the early days of me playing, but
this is beyond that. Where you had told me that you were now starting to make your decks based off of, you know, knowing like if I pull these mana cards now or these mana or these monsters later, it won't matter because you have a more balanced deck.
The 1/3 option.
Right. Exactly.
Right.
Exactly. And I know that changes.
No, but I love
you got
that.
Your big dog.
And that's kind of why I like Eye of Judgment too. I mean, I'm just, you know, I like that you're forced into this random, so now you have to think of that kind of strategy. I actually enjoy that. So.
All right. Anything
it's an
else,
awesome
Brian?
Game. Stop hating on it.
Yeah. You guys, I like the way the show was yesterday and stuff, where it was the open format and stuff, and how people were able to call in and stuff is cool. Yeah, you guys rock. And,
Thank you, sir.
Keep on doing good job you do. Peace.
Peace, dog. Peace. We appreciate the call.
Those are good calls. Why did we get bad calls yesterday?
What do you mean?
Well, that one guy that called
us. We had one guy that said he wanted to stick his cock in my ass. But this guy definitely wants to stick his penis in my butt. It's Zeke. What's up?
Ooh, man, the mole's returning. I didn't know that.
Oh, shit. All of a sudden, see, when you listen to EG and Faces for Radio, you learn something other than video games, don't you? Yeah, thank you. Will you tell these guys how fucking awesome the mole was?
Anderson Cooper was he's like the best host for any reality show.
Yeah, he was great.
Is he making a return to the new one?
It's unclear. They have not announced a host yet, which is a little scary because they say it's supposed to come out soon.
Marcus, DJ Wheat Graham.
Oh, I would host it in a second. I would be the mole, and I'd be the host.
We need to fill out our Big Brother apps. I mean, we need to just stop.
We do. I'm so excited about the mole. Yeah, go ahead.
Did you guys hear about NASA attempting to run Crisis at maximum settings?
No.
What?
NASA had to get involved now? They're not. It's not like we got spaceships to fucking build, guys.
What?
It's not like we need to go to Mars. It's not like we need to fucking become a Type 1 civilization. Okay? Instead, they're fucking getting Crisis to run at maximum settings. Dude, I would like our civilization to fucking evolve, okay?
Is that what I'm
saying?
Can
NASA get on the ball and fucking get on the moon so we can find this little fucking robot that will let us colonize and become a Type 1 civilization?
Hey, it's a Type 4.
Jesus Christ, man. No, seriously, were they successful?
Well, they were running on a custom-built Cray XT3 Operon supercomputer, and they got it to run for 10 minutes until...
How did they design the game? How did they make it, then? If NASA's supercomputer
Until
it
shut down?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Shot on them.
Well, how did they make it? Did they make it with some future machine that only those developers own? I don't understand.
Maybe they did,
Some alien technology?
Maybe probably... To my question, when you played it, was it at like maximum settings?
Fuck no, dude. You think I got a Cray supercomputer in my house? Dog.
But I heard you say that you said you played it with a system that was really good.
Okay, let me clear that up. So I went to the NVIDIA GeForce LAN, right? And one of their premier titles was Crysis. And they had, you know, these baller-ass machines, dude. They had, like, 8800 GTX, SLI, fucking, you know, mad quad-core, like, 8 gigs of RAM, blah, blah, blah. And Crysis ran good. Was it running at max settings? Probably not, but it looked damn good enough that I probably would have mistaken it for max settings. So then when I actually got my copy home and playing, I was playing it on a single core laptop, 7800 NVIDIA, you know, GeForce Go. And yeah, I mean, honestly, the frame rate, it was like low to maybe medium settings. So it was not pretty, dude.
There's a Fat Baby says there's a new Warhawk trailer up. Not that that means. I don't know why he's telling me that in the middle of the show.
Thanks, Fat Baby.
It says NASA comes closer to running Crysis at maximum settings. There it is right there.
Apparently, there's a Chinese competitor who's trying to beat him to it.
What? It's like, I don't get it. Wait, hold on. Let's see. This has been a real journey for the whole team.
God.
Even a few months ago, we weren't able to put the sliders up past half before it crippled the system. Now we're playing for 5-10 minutes at a time at full resolution with no administrative frame lag.
When's NASA going to tackle that Super Mario Galaxy? Try and get it running at full res.
Wow. That's crazy, dude. That's the first I'd heard of that.
Yeah, it's pretty odd.
It is odd.
Wow.
Again.
Good job, government.
Again, yeah. Way to spend our money, you know? It's not like we got troops over in Iraq or, you know, homeless people or fucking old people that can't get paid and shit. We got to worry about running crisis at high settings. Great. Thanks a lot. I'm not sure why it was on that screen during that speech.
See, Europe again. Because another reason Europe is better than the U.S.
Because you were crying, and I didn't want people to see your tears, Summa. All right, Zeke, anything else?
Yeah, one more thing. Props to you guys and your production team for Up All Night. It was pretty good.
Mad thank
very
you.
Good.
Thank mad you. Props to Mahmood, Chachi, Don,
Tyler, Cammy.
And, of course, the talent actually gets the most props.
Talent made it.
Wouldn't even be anything without the talent.
That's right. That's right. Thanks. We appreciate that, bro.
All right. Thanks for taking my call.
Of course. Anytime. Take care.
See ya.
Peace.
And thank you to Hogan and Cammy for writing down when we had special moments.
I already said that.
I didn't hear you.
We got 40 minutes left.
I was too busy thinking about
myself.
For
radio. Yeah, you were.
These are on iTunes, right?
What?
These are a podcast now?
Basically. Yes, they are. Up All Nights are not.
Guys,
however.
iTunes. Yeah. If you want to support the show, go in there, rate the show, write a review. We can't say that
right
enough.
Now, we only have 9 reviews.
Yeah,
do you know how many reviews we need?
I know you guys want to say fuck
over 9,000!
iTunes.
Yeah.
Fuck iTunes.
We need that
many
fucking reviews.
Just go in there and do it. I don't care.
Not 9 reviews, but
it's over 9,000!
9,000 fucking reviews.
Make an alt account. I don't care. Make 20 alt accounts. Just do it.
We want reviews.
Yes.
And subscriptions.
Very important.
Yes.
And more important now than you could ever imagine.
Yes. And for the record, you has been healed by the power of Jesus.
And you don't have to pay for it on iTunes. You can download iTunes for free. You can download our shows for free. You're not paying for anything.
Dude, are cat photos the greatest thing in the world? Aren't they?
They beat out Kotaku as
well. They did. What was it? Ihasacheeseburger.com?
Yeah, something like that.
Let's see. I has a cheeseburger. How can you even find it?
Is there orange juice left? Or?
No.
Oh, okay. I can
Is
has
there Coke
cheeseburger.
Left or anything?
Oh, it's I can have cheeseburger, dude.
I can has cheeseburger.com.
Universe. I control it.
Well, it is better. I agree. Sure.
Dude, these fucking pictures are epic. Because this is Thriller.
Oh, boy.
That's not a cat.
When, will that ever get old? Oh, I hate the bug.
Oh, my God.
This is great for our podcast, people.
I love it. I love it. Now safe to disconnect.
For those just listening to audio, we're looking at cat pictures.
We're looking at cat pictures.
And they're adorable.
Yeah, they are.
This one's adorable. Help. Let me picture it for you. It's adorable, and it's a kid.
And there's 90 pages of this shit
and,
for you to go through.
They make $1 million a month.
Yeah, if you like this kind of stuff, cute overload is also really good. But most of my stuff I get off of, like, 4chan, which would have a picture like this, and then it would say, like, get the fuck off my internets, or, you know, something like that. Do they have a most popular here? You know, there was something else that I found that
I
was
like
pretty fucking epic. I don't know if you guys really shared my enthusiasm the other day.
Probably not.
I don't think you did. But,
cool.
Let me see. Maybe some people would enjoy this. Did
DJ
you love it?
DJ Two Times seems to think people on the internet like boobs more than they like cats.
No way, dude. No way,
what
dude.
A moron.
All right.
What a moron.
All right, I want to find a good one. All right, this one might be.
I got boobs, look.
This one, hold on. This one. Is it this one? This one right here was actually, I was pretty surprised at the outcome.
Yeah, Two Times.
Oh, wait,
we
no,
like
this isn't
more.
The one.
Come on.
Son of a bitch. Oh, it's this one right here. All right, guys, this is my new hobby. I spent
gay porn.
I spent 20 minutes at work this morning, watching this, and
Sir Thrust a lot.
Night.
Oh yeah, we watched this last night. You're gonna spoil
Enjoy.
Our
idea.
Wait,
no,
can we
I'm
show
not.
The Hornet? Can we show?
That's
the
right, you guys. It's time for Scorpion versus
Get
Tarantula.
Get him!
All right.
Okay. We obviously the.
All right.
The black tarantula.
Now,
waves
let's talk
scorpion.
About this. Yeah, because the black tarantula looks like it could probably fuck this scorpion
up,
right?
I mean, the scorpion probably has quickness.
Well, the scorpion's got
right?
venom, too. Don't forget about that, okay?
Does the tarantula have venom?
So far, hold on, let me close ads by Google. So far, okay, they're not doing shit.
Look at that stinger, though.
Obviously, the scorpion doesn't give two shits that the tarantula is there.
He's scoping out the arena.
And the tarantula doesn't give two shits that the scorpion's there. But pretty soon.
They're humping each other now.
That's all going to change.
No. Is that a carcass there from the previous battle?
Oh, that might be. Right down there. Yeah, there is. There's a little piece. Oh, now it starts to get fucking intense.
Look at that range.
The scorpion's going in for a kill.
Look at his range.
Look,
his range is obviously.
The tarantula tried to stop. Look, he's using his claws here.
Back
he's going to try to go in for the killing blow, folks. Did he do it? I don't know.
I think he spent
too
much
energy. The tarantula's still moving. Tarantula's he's going to go for another one, folks. He's going to go for another one right here. Tarantula looks like
he's
going to try to escape away.
Left on the floor.
Yeah, dude, there's like bug parts all over here.
Oh, God. It's a bloodbath.
JapaneseBugFights.com, ladies and gentlemen. There's all sorts of.
The scorpion's probably thinking about a strat here.
Yeah, someone's got to win here, right? Okay.
Obviously, the tarantula doesn't care.
The scorpion, he's going to try to get full guard. He's going to try to get full guard, going for a sting, dude. How do you think the venom of a scorpion could do? Oh, that might be it. That might be it.
Well, what can the tarantula honestly do? I mean, all the tarantula can do is sit on him.
That scorpion got fucking worked.
How?
I mean, I'm sorry, that tarantula just got fucking worked.
Is the tarantula dead?
The tarantula is dead, dog.
Wow.
There you go.
Dude, it was just laid there dead. That was not as good as the other one.
There you go. I actually, I want to show you one other one real quick. And we don't have to watch
the Hornet one?
We don't have to watch the
Hornet.
Whole thing. But there is one.
Someone says beetle.
There is one. There is a scorpion versus scorpion battle that is very, very
even.
Interesting. Yes. Well, I mean, I don't know if you want to call it even. Because
it's a different kind of scorpion.
It is.
Not the scorpion from wrestling fame.
There's two different types of scorpions, but I can't seem to find it now.
What was the name of that WCW? Not the scorpion from WCW.
What?
Wasn't there a scorpion in WCW?
I don't know.
Remember WCW?
I remember WCW. Oh, here it is.
Sting.
Here it is. Right. Sting?
I guess.
Oh my God, dude!
There was a scorpion.
You called him fucking scorpion, dude. He's like one of the biggest names in wrestling, next to like Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man.
There had to be a scorpion. All right.
All right. So I'm not gonna show the whole video. I want to go to the end here. Okay. There's a 3 minute battle.
Wow.
Between. This scorpion and this other scorpion.
Oh, guys, back.
Watch what happens here when this scorpion actually gets stung, dude. You will see the true power of the venom. And here it comes, right here. Watch it. Here it goes. Get him.
Oh, that's in his spinal column.
Watch this. Watch this. This scorpion. Oh, my
God.
There it is. It's over. It's over. It's fucking over.
Oh,
there it is. Yeah. Yeah.
Money shot.
Dude.
Power
and
mode
no multi fighter. Greatness. Greatness.
Wow.
That is the most deadly
scorpion right there.
That's the most deadly scorpion right there. Very, very nice job, Scorpion.
The best round.
All right, we got a call. We've got from the UK. Oliver's on the horn. What's up?
Oi.
I gotta say, that was actually pretty creepy.
Dude, JapaneseBugFights.com. 30 different bug fights for you to enjoy later on. Dude, trust me. When you see a centipede, take on a fucking Japanese hornet, your mind's gonna be fucking blown, dog. All right.
Yeah,
what's up, man?
I was just wondering what you thought of The Sims 3.
I gotta say.
What were the details? I didn't really read the details.
The details are that they're adding all sorts of emotion and all sorts of cool stuff, but the bottom line is it looks like Sims 2.
What more can you do with
Right? I think if I had a computer to handle it, I would actually maybe be down with it. I'm just putting
What do you think, caller? I mean, I felt a little underwhelmed. I got to be honest with you. I felt like it looked a lot like Sims 2.
Yeah, I mean, I looked at the site, like, it says coming in 2009. Yeah, like, yeah, I was like, yeah, whatever. And then I looked at the details, and one of the details was new creator sim. Create any sim you can imagine. Well,
they already have that,
right?
Yeah,
the very first game.
Yeah, exactly. The first game let you...
You know,
the
only thing I didn't like about the first one was, like, the time. The time was way too fast. I don't know if that was fixed in Sims 2 or what, but...
Well, yeah, you don't have to send your sim to the fucking bathroom
anymore.
Yeah,
I hated that.
Dude.
I hated having to go
so
to the bathroom.
So, here's a screenshot, okay? I don't feel like I'm seeing anything. Yeah, here's... Okay, so, like, yeah, this model is a little bit better than what they had in Sims 2.
Well, they can't make it too advanced. I mean, this is for moms and stuff.
Well, that is true. That is true. There you can see you can go jogging in The Sims 3. We can plant marijuana plants.
I'm trying to plant a plant here.
And here's where they're cooking meth because the marijuana plants aren't fully, you know, they aren't fully grown yet. And here is where they throw all their luxury cocaine parties. And
that's the crack house.
This is just a
store.
That's
where the naked chicks bake crack.
Store. This is just a store, Summa. However, this is where they buy all of the drugs that
that's
they
the
need
front.
To make the meth.
That's the front,
so.
Right?
The thing is that we could sit here and we could sort of make fun of Sims 3 and how scared all these guys are because they're watching a repeat of Friends on this TV. But the bottom line is it's still going to sell a shitload of copies.
It'll be the best-selling PC game
for about
5 years.
You know, it looks great. Will Wright doesn't lead you wrong.
Well, I don't know if Will Wright has anything to do with the Sims.
Well, maybe he doesn't at this point. Maybe he doesn't.
He does.
But
I would pretty much say he doesn't.
You know, this will definitely be one that I played The Sims 2 a little bit. I enjoyed it a little bit.
I enjoyed The Sims.
For very long.
I didn't play The Sims 2, but I did enjoy The Sims when it first came out. I enjoyed killing my Sims and locking them in rooms and setting them on fire and things like that.
Oliver, are you excited for this, or are you a little underwhelmed like we are?
A little bit underwhelmed. I mean, one of the new features was that it's a living neighborhood. Your Sims explore the living neighborhood freely. I mean, at least this time I won't have to catch a taxi or anything like that to go and visit someone else's house.
Right, right, right. And, you know, that was, you know, one of the things that they sort of, I know that people in Sims 2 complained about is, like, you sort of had this block, and then whenever you went somewhere else, it sort of was, like, detached from the, you know, from your home and from the rest of the city. And in this particular case, like you said, you can literally go across the street to your neighbor's house and, you know, interact with them. So it seems like it adds a little bit of SimCity Societies where it tries to, like, you know, AI an entire town versus, like, doing sections, which is what Sims 2 kind of did. So.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I guess we'll just have to wait till some more details are released. But,
I mean,
yeah.
It's 2009. It's still way off.
Yeah, still a long ways away. 2009 is fucking forever, it seems like. So, anything else, Oliver?
Thank you for bringing the show to a grinding halt with your Sims talk.
Oh, wait. Oliver hung up. Oliver, you got any? Did you have anything else before you got cut off?
I was just wondering what type of sim you're going to create out of all this.
What type of sim I'm going to create?
A ball of crack
marijuana
selling.
Right.
Sim.
I don't know. I always usually create Sims based off of the people I know. That's always the most fun to me. You know, like, when I'm, like, playing a Sims, I'll be like, okay, I'm going to create me. Okay, I'm going to create my
Montagna.
Son. It's like, okay, this was going to be Summa Sim. You know, this is going to be the camera Sim. You know, I don't know. I just, maybe I'm fucking lame like that. But whenever I do play these games, I actually just use the people
did.
That I know to
that's
make
what
Sims
I did in college,
out.
College, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe that means I have no imagination.
Rocket says you'll make an underage schoolgirl.
Maybe I will. Maybe I'll make two of them and make them kiss. How about that? How about that, bitch? We'll have a little Sims Yuri going on. Sims Loli Yuri. How about that? And there's nothing wrong with that. Not a damn thing. All right.
FBI's involved.
Thank you for your call, brother.
No problem, guys. You rock.
Thanks,
see you later, guys.
Take care. Bye-bye. Man, staying up so late just to listen to Faces for Radio, you got to give the Euros prop.
I love Europe, again. Wish I could live there.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't.
Socialism? Hot chicks.
No, you don't.
They smell. You don't have to shower. You don't have to shower.
Area code 941 is on the air. What's up, buddy?
They wear awful clothing.
No, yo, what's going on?
What's up? I want to hear some feedback on Call of Duty 4 for the PS3.
It's awesome.
What kind of feedback
are
you looking for?
It's completely awesome.
I don't know. Just reviews, anything.
100.
Do you have a PS3?
10, A+.
Yep.
Dude, it's a must-have, bro. I got it. You got it?
Well, then what do you
know? Yeah. Fuck, man. You don't need our opinions on it. You just got to play that bitch for 6 hours, and you know it's awesome. Dude, have you been playing the hell out of it then, or are you just wondering? Okay, so, I mean, dude, I'll give you short version of it.
Best game
first off,
ever made
the
last
single
year.
Player fucking owned all. The single player was fantastic.
Online is the best.
Oh, but online, exactly. But that's the beauty
the
of it, dude.
It set the bar.
The beauty of
it
was
the standard and the bar.
Is that Call of Duty 4 gave me an unbelievable single player experience from start to finish.
Yep.
And then I hopped online, and suddenly, if I wouldn't have even played the single player game, it wouldn't have even fucking mattered because the multiplayer is a perfect 10. In fact, in some circles, it's a fucking 11, dude. I think it's phenomenal. Yeah, dude, you need to, if you've got it, you need to hop in one of these EG nights with us on Saturday nights and fucking play some Call of Duty 4 with some of the other EG fans.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, all right. Well, hopefully we'll see you.
Okay.
All right, bro.
Fuck
thanks for your call, man.
All right, peace out.
Bye.
My ass and suck on my balls.
Call of Duty 4, man. Fucking fantastic sauce. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. All right.
Dude, seriously,
they're
going to the
fucking
year.
Remake Karate
you
Kid.
You know what?
Dude.
Fucking Call of Duty 4 took BioShock, sat it on the floor, put a nice little, you know, rose next to it maybe, and then opened its ass and shat upon it. All right? Call of Duty 4 was
Call of
far
Duty
and
4
away a better
shat
game.
Into the ass of BioShock?
Shat on the face.
So does
of
that
BioShock,
mean? Oh,
the face.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, yes. I thought
it two girls one cup to BioShock.
Because wouldn't that mean that then BioShock had twice as much shit to shit on another game when it
maybe okay that's how awesome Call
and
Duty
even if
was.
You shat on his face wouldn't he have digested said shat and still shat it out
quality anyway. Call of Duty 4 shat.
We've got about 22 minutes left on the show. You can reach us by dialing 866-408-4448. Of course, now after talking about shat and BioShock.
Shard stains.
No one really wants to call in after that. I mean, how do you follow up with something like that? I don't know.
And showers.
I've run out of things to talk about on my car. Or on my card. on my card, fucker.
On my car.
All right, we got Deathsaw calling in again because the phone lines apparently are slow. Deathsaw, what's up?
What?
Yeah,
after everyone complained about not being able to
call
in?
Apparently, since the phone lines are slow.
No. Just ignore Summa.
Yeah, I know. I learned to ignore the majority of
all right, hold on. We said that, not me.
Just because you
all.
Got fast dialing fingers doesn't mean it's a bad call. All right, what's up, man?
Well, what do you guys think about Red Faction 3, or Red Faction Guerrilla, as they're calling
it's
it?
It's too bad
because
that Force...
honestly, I was a huge fan of Red Faction 2.
I
tunnels in the walls and shit.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, dude.
I think I've done that on a level of, you know, Crackdown Summa here, when you just shot out tires all day, man. I've just dug tunnels all day.
You liked Red Faction, Summa?
I like the original, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that is like Force loves Red Faction. Like, I was talking to him the other day. We were talking about Red Faction recently was featured in Game
Informer. That was one of the few games I beat, you know, or growing up.
And, you know,
in college.
They say that they're going to, again, bring completely 150% destructible environments that are just going to fucking
rock
people.
Red Faction was awesome, dude.
Yeah, it was. Like, that was...
Yeah, I'm excited for that.
And to think about they were doing that shit on the PS2, dude. Okay?
Oh, I played it on PC. I don't know.
Oh, okay. I played it on the PS2, and it was still amazing. So what are they going to be able to do on the PS3? My God, I have no idea. Certainly, it's going to be fucking awesome, though.
Oh, really? You don't know the details?
What?
No, I don't know
the details. Do you know the details of it? Like... You're going to be able to go, it's kind of like a sandbox world where your actions actually do matter. And let's just say you go to a base, like a communication center, and you blow that up. They're not going to be able to communicate in the world, your enemy. But if you go away for a few, oh, yeah, that's hot.
Yeah.
Anyway, but
kissing girls.
You go away for a few hours and you come back. That's going to be rebuilt unless you just cripple how they build things. So you have to.
I didn't know it was supposed to be. I actually didn't know it was sandbox. That's pretty badass. Huh.
Yeah.
Maybe I should actually go back and read that article instead of just looking at the pictures.
Yeah, I think you should.
Okay. All right. Well, you should call back when Force is on the show so he can, like, have a geek orgasm with you, because I know that he is just like, oh, my God.
Force is too busy playing Bully.
Yeah, he's playing Bully for the second fucking time, I know. Dude.
Oh, boy. Come on, man. And, why did they even make that game on the 360?
He's playing it on the 360. He's already lost, like, 2 hours because of freezes, and I know a patch is coming. But I'm like, dude, you already played it once. If I played this game once and decided to play it again on the 360, the first time that I experienced this freeze, I would have fucking chucked that goddamn game out of the window. So.
Yeah, same here if I even went through the first time.
Right.
But Red Faction, I'll definitely be keeping an eye on, dude. And with that being said,
definitely.
Thank you for your call, brother.
Hey, no problem.
All right.
Hey, I'll keep trying when the phone lines are slow so I can just keep bringing up intelligent discussion.
We
appreciate
that. All the other callers out.
Oh, you did.
Kyle. Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's okay. All right, man. Take care. Peace.
All right, see ya.
Oh, boy. I don't know if I want to show that one. The FCC might, Wow, what is going on there?
Let me see it.
It's a penis.
Know. All right, we got enough. I don't know if I'm going to take his call.
The forums are down, evidently.
Oh, yeah? What's fucking new? Yeah, so did Skype just went down, too.
What was it?
I don't know.
What was what?
It's a giant penis.
I'm bringing Skype back up, guys. Sorry if you were trying to call. I know, like, eight people.
The internet is down in general.
Hey, is there a tattoo on his dong?
Yeah, it may have. Wait, the site is up, but the forums are down?
I don't know.
Just more work that I got to do. That's awesome.
Oh, this is bad.
Well, that's okay. We only got about 14 minutes left on the show. Put that on your chest, Suma. There you go. That's how it's supposed to be done.
Oh, yeah.
I can't even get to... the forums aren't down. The goddamn website is down, period. Why is...
Yes? My... Ow!
Hello.
Jesus.
Why did the burnt matches just call the show?
I didn't.
Yes, you did. It fucking said Cammy the burnt matches on the goddamn Skype. Okay.
It's your mom.
It's possible there could be another Cammy the burnt matches out there on the internet. It's totally possible. But I'm pretty fucking sure that it came from your iPhone. And with that being said, we've got Talkwork on the line.
Yo, man.
Again?
What games can you suggest to play this? I mean, what games are you going to be playing mainly this
weekend?
Spring break.
Spring break? Yeah. Dude,
who the fuck is
spring break?
I graduated college in 2001.
Yeah. We got spring break up here.
Oh, I didn't realize.
What games are you going to be playing next week?
Spring break, middle school. Okay,
didn't spring break
gotcha.
Happen
High
even...
school.
Middle school, I understand.
Yeah, but isn't everyone's spring break different?
Yeah, I think so, because, I mean, I heard that some guys in California are having it. And
I heard there's a fucking awesome Sherlock Holmes game for
evidently,
the PC.
Evidently, GGL.com is down.
I'm asking here, is there any good, like, some PC RPGs? Because I'm burnt out, man. I can't find anything good to play this.
Yeah, it's called sell your PC and buy a console, because that's where all the
Shut
games
the fuck
are.
Up and let the guy that actually knows about gaming talk for a second.
Get
okay?
The Witcher, dude.
I'm going to give you a secret. Okay, you guys are all like, we doesn't know fucking shit about PC games,
that's
blah,
true.
Blah. All right, well, how about this? Okay, there's a site out there called Independent Games. Okay, Talkwork, there's a site out there called Independent Games. And recently, Independent Games has done a feature on several Japanese PC-based RPGs that have been completely translated. Okay? Mm-hmm. So these are, like, the most popular RPGs from Japan played on the PC. And no, there's not, like, tentacle hentai RPGs. These are, like, you know, fantasy-style, very deep. You know how the Japanese RPGs are. They're very, like,
boring.
Deep and blah, blah, blah.
What's the link?
Generic.
Well, I'm going to have to take a guess that it's independentgames.com, but...
I just went to its... didn't get anything.
Okay, hold on. Independent Games. Fucking A, man.
If you want a game where there's an effeminate male, generic storyline, And turn-based gameplay.
God damn it. What the fuck is the name of that site?
With cloud type hair.
God, I was like looking at it today. It's not indiegames.com, maybe?
Twoguysonetop.com?
TGI Source. Look at all these.
No, this isn't it.
Talkinyourmouth.com.
I would actually have to go to my computer to find out.
Independent gaming?
Penis.
Is that it? Oh, maybe that's it. Maybe that's it.
Indiegamer.blogspot.
Indiegames.
No.
Oh, we got 15 minutes.
Gamers,
God,
did you say?
I gotta go to the bathroom so bad.
No.
Why can I not find this?
I think indiegames.com, I think that's it. IE instead of a Y. I think that's it.
The little icon is like a black little IG. I'll tell you what. I'm actually so curious to know what the fuck it is that I'm going to get up. And camera, take the show for
I'll
the next 2 minutes.
I'll do all of it.
Oh, my God.
Today on Faces for Radio, we're going to talk about the Nintendo Wii.
I'm not
and,
facing the right way.
We just want you guys to just take your Wiimote and,
shove it up your fucking asses, motherfucker.
Imagine you're taking it up, Summa's butt.
No, seriously, Cameron,
guys,
let me ask you a question.
All right.
This question comes up all the time. And
Wait. Pass right.
Excuse me, Summa. I'm
done. Pass right.
No. What do you think about,
where did we go?
Rayman Raving Rabbits 2.
Best game ever.
Okay.
Game of the year. What happened to my earphones? All right. You got all mutated.
I got it.
Oh,
bro.
You left too, huh?
You were right. indiegamer.blogspot.com. That is right.
Yep.
This is so professional, says Cage.
But this isn't the page that I go to. What the fuck, man?
They have a new website, they said, indiegames.com.
Oh, okay. So, see, I just haven't updated it. What you need to do, just search through this page, look through it. They've got several Japanese RPGs for the PC that have been completely translated with links and everything to get all set up. I'd give it a shot, dude.
I am. Seems interesting. They got some old school, I guess. That's what they're about.
Yeah, ignore the fact that like this is an indie games website. They also support guys that like have done indie sort of translations for these games as well.
Uh-huh.
So
have you ever played any of the Neverwinter Nights games or any of those?
No. I played like Baldur Gates and shit, but
I'm trying to find a good RPG, but I'll check the website out.
Have you played The Witcher yet?
All right. There it is.
I have, but it runs shit on my computer.
Oh.
That sucks.
I'm thinking about just getting it because
a lot
of people say
have you ever played
good
Dungeon
things about
Siege?
It.
Have you ever played Dungeon Siege?
Dungeon Siege, no.
Pick that up.
I love that game.
Space Siege is coming out soon.
I know, but if your computer can't handle The Witcher, you might be able to pick up Dungeon Siege and enjoy it. Is what I'm saying.
Yeah, I'll check that out. Thanks, guys.
All
peace.
Right, peace. Take care. Really appreciate that. That's it. Fantastic call. Love it. Hey, here's one.
That was fantastic.
Rhapsody is an upcoming indie RPG similar to Japanese-style RPG for the NES and early PlayStation titles. We've got a lot of shit on here, you guys. A lot of shit. Anyway, we got about 10 minutes left on the show, and so now is your last chance.
12 minutes, actually.
We got our next caller on the horn. Caller, what's up?
What's up? I want to hear about Universe at War.
I haven't played it yet, dude. But
it's a cross-platform one you can play on the PS, 360 and the PC.
Right.
Yes, and it's made by Sega, too, and like Sega doesn't exactly have like an amazing track record for RTSs, but I've actually heard people who have played it say it's really not that bad.
You had some strong feelings of it, didn't you?
Me? Universe at War?
Version?
What?
The PC version?
Universe at War.
Yes.
I've never played Universe at War. I've played World in Conflict, if that's what you're thinking about.
No, that's not what I'm thinking about.
Universe at War is, am I correct, caller? It's like it's a RTS made by Sega,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, all I've heard about it is actually decent things from people who have, said, hey, this is actually a pretty decent game. I have not personally played it myself.
2 inches says
It's an RTS for people who are not used to RTS.
So it's kind of like a, it's kind of like more like, I don't know, pixel junk? I don't know.
Universe at War, Earth Assault.
Have you played it, or are you wondering if you should play it?
I'm wondering if I should, if it's actually worth buying.
Do you ever rent games?
Yeah, I rent games.
You know, that's always the other way to go. I mean, I'm sure you could hop down to your local Blockbuster or whatever and pick that title up and check it out.
I could probably get it from Gamefly, too.
Yeah, Gamefly. And who knows? I mean, Universal War's been out a while. You might be able to pick it up at a used game
shop. I like the feature of the cross-platform functionality.
It's pretty badass. Of course, a guy with a mouse and keyboard might fucking lay waste to you, so just keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I don't know. I mean, they say that it's a little bit more balanced so that it works better on PC or on console. Yeah. So, I unfortunately have not had a chance to check it out. I heard a lot of great things before its release and even after its release. Those who did give it a chance have reported to me that it's actually quite a good title. So there you go.
Fast.
That's what I know, man. Anything else?
All right. Nope.
All right, man. Take care.
Thank you.
Peace. Maybe that caller will...
never call again.
Let us know if he enjoyed the game or not.
Oh.
We've got just under 10 minutes left, and another edition of Faces for Radio is about ready to fucking
good job on
close.
The bug fights, because now everyone in Stick'Em is watching different
fuck
bug
yeah,
fights.
Japanese
well, now everyone's
bug...
watching bug fights in the show.
Well, guess what? They aren't understanding a goddamn word. We got Mac19 on the motherfucking phone lines. Mac19, what's up?
What's up? Nothing much.
I like how it says you're all calling right. from South Korea.
Well, maybe is. I am.
You're not, dude.
You don't know.
I know.
I got a question and I got some comments.
All right. Comments.
All right, first question is,
question.
When are you giving out that Dead or Alive 4 signed by Master?
We gave it out, dude. We gave it out.
You did?
You didn't hear about it?
When did that happen?
Dude, you didn't hear?
No.
What the fuck, man?
Did
yeah,
Camera take it?
Camera won
Santa
it.
Santa Claus gave it?
Camera won it. Camera won it. All right. Ha ha. So funny. What's your other question, comment?
My other question / comment is, since Nietzsche didn't call in and seemed like you did, what do you think of the Shippuden?
So I watched.
Oh
I wa- shut the fuck
first
up.
First Japanese
I know,
RPGs, the- and now Shippuden. Why don't I just
well,
get a pillow
no good colors,
and go to
so
sleep?
My honest opinion is this: I really felt like last night's episode was fairly underwhelming. I liked
really?
It. Well, I mean, you know, I mean, I liked it, but at the same time, I want to see the battle. I'm ready for the fucking battle.
Yeah.
And I don't even know if there is a battle, to be honest, because I'm not keeping up on the manga.
Spoilers!
But
I want spoilers!
I haven't even said. I said
know.
A battle,
people
okay?
Spoilers.
People fucking... If you're not watching Shippuden the day it's released, then you're fucking noob anyway. So,
yeah.
I liked it, dude. I think that the next episode or they're going to have like a 2-week break or something, that's really where the shit's going to be going down. Oh. And if you notice next week I think it's 2 or 2.5 weeks whenever the next one comes out, it is also a double episode. Mm. So I'm guessing that they kind of put this double episode out so they could get rid of all the
What film. Website can people go to?
DateBio.com. DateBio. Wakara DateBio.
SausageKey.com.
Kirinatebayo! Tabemasu datebayo!
Oh my god. What is going on right now?
Well, you know, like, the whole thing behind datebayo is that he just basically says a verb, and then.
Yeah. Believe it!
At the end of
he
the verb.
Says it a lot,
at the end of the verb, he would say datebayo. So it'd be like, Tabemasu datebayo! Which would be like, I'm eating, believe it!
Did we ever play that Korean thing? Korean history thing?
What?
Did we ever play the Korean history thing?
Japanese dinosaur. No, I haven't. But datebayo.com. It's D-A-T-T-B-E. Oh. Or wait. D-A-T-T-E-B-A-Y-O.com. Datebayo. And all the torrents are there. It's awesome.
And I assume I got a question. What size shoe are you?
13, brother. You know what that
13?
Means. 13? I have a big foot.
Awesome.
Sanju datebayo.
So how about them? So yeah, awesome. All
right, bro.
All my questions have been answered. Thanks. All right. See everybody later.
Sayonara date,
bayo. He wanted to know about my shoe size.
Yeah, he's gonna send you something.
Oh.
Yeah.
Naruto shoes?
No, a pair of fucking cement shoes, bitch.
Cement shoes.
Oh my God, cement shoes. Come on. Have you not watched enough fucking Sopranos to know what fucking cement shoes are? You fucking.
Right.
God, didn't you see fucking, what the fuck was that guy's name? Fucking
pussy?
Geraldo Guerrero or Geraldo, fucking, what is Geraldo?
Geraldo Rivera.
Rivera.
Dumbass.
Well, didn't you see it when he fucking uncovered the secrets of Al Capone's tomb live on TV? And there's nothing in there but like old farts
Thank
and
you
dust.
For bringing up 20-year-old news. Anything
well,
else you want?
You know what?
You want to tell me Princess Diana got killed?
I'm sorry that my fucking brain works on a 20-year cycle instead of you, where you work like a fucking goldfish and 30 seconds goes by and you fucking don't know what happened in the previous fucking 30 seconds, okay?
And the Challenger had a teacher on it and it went up in the air and it blew up.
January 28th, 1986, bitch.
No, it happened while I was in school. You're wrong. Oh, January 28th. Okay.
January 28th, 1986, motherfucker! You want to try to go? My brain works on a fucking 20-year cycle! Your brain fucking works like a goldfish! Oh, my God. Yeah, man.
We watched it in school.
Yeah, it was like, all right, guys, all
right, yeah.
Let's get all the kids together.
This awesome shuttle launch,
that was
everyone.
Actually crazy. It fucking was crazy. They were like, okay, the whole school's going to get together because, guys,
awesome.
There's a teacher up on the. But here's the fucked up part, right, is that I'm in third grade and we're watching it and half of the class is like, and the other class, realizing that there's a teacher on board, is like, fuck yeah! One less teacher in the world!
Now you know why we're all so messed up. This
it was,
we all had to watch the Challenger blow
the
up.
The Challenger.
Best little kids.
Dude, I mean, you know what? For me, that was, and a lot of people, and I would have bet a lot of the viewers of EG, you know, and I know this is like completely going off of any subject, but like 9/11 was that moment for them. But like for us, dude, I'm not shitting you. When you watched 9/11, you saw the towers fall 80 fucking thousand times. Guess what? When the Challenger blow up, you saw it every 30 seconds. Just in case you didn't see the Challenger blow up 30 seconds ago, here it is. Let's watch it one more time. Roll that. Roll that, Tom.
Now, as you can
see, all you guys that got fucking brains like a goldfish out there, let's see the Challenger blowing up one more time. Roll that shit, Tom.
As you can see, her arm is basically detached. I mean, look at that. It's awesome.
And then they're like,
apparently there's been a problem. It's like they're still talking like terms, even though it's like been 3 minutes and the shuttle blew up. It's like it's obvious to everyone that the shuttle has blown up. We're not getting any readings on the left booster. maybe it's because the fucking shuttle blew up.
It was sad, dude. It was
sad. 2 inches says that Mythbusters prove that goldfish have good memories.
How the fuck did Mythbusters prove? Did they make a fucking goldfish maze and the fucking goldfish had to swim through the fucking maze?
It's
how
true.
The fuck does Mythbusters prove?
It's true.
And I think
Television
that's fucking bullshit.
Television doesn't
well,
lie.
If that doesn't lie, guess where I learned to guess
Bad
where
Baby
I,
even says they made a maze.
If television doesn't lie,
goldfish
I learned
than you.
That goldfish have 30-second memories from television. So there you go.
Well, they live for 30 seconds.
I'm looking this up. Goldfish.
Mythbusters.
I think
some guy has been trying to call in, by the way, and hasn't been able to get through.
Well, guess what?
Regular number.
There's like no fucking calls coming in right now, so it seems like now would be the time for him to call.
Yeah, Mally says it's true. Why do they swim to the top when they need to be fed? Well, that's probably more instinct.
Hey, it's time, Wheat.
It's time. It's time. Sorry, guy who's been trying to call. Sorry, guy.
It's sorry momentary. He says it rings once and then beeps in.
All right, dude.
Momentary.
I will.
It's called from a number.
I will. Oh, there it is. All right. All right. Area code 603.
Is this momentary?
Hello.
I'm looking it up right now, but Mythbusters proved it.
No, it's not momentary.
Dude.
how did Mythbusters fucking prove that
they made a maze?
They made a fucking maze.
Any other insult you want to try and throw my way? That can be proven wrong by Mythbusters?
Whatever, dude. Well, what? So they're like, it's got it. So maybe it's not.
All over it.
See, dude. I can find myself out of a maze. Confirmed.
Great. So they don't have a 30-second memory. They've got like 59 seconds. Fair enough.
Hey, that's all you need.
Yeah, probably something like that.
I succumb. Okay. Sorry, Suma. Your memory isn't 30 seconds.
Thank you. It's a fucking whopping
59
and
seconds.
And way to go, Wheat. Now Momentaria doesn't want to call anymore. Tell him that he made him cut himself. Tell him.
Sorry. Made him cut Sorry, himself. Emo.
Momentaria
Sorry about that.
Now cut himself because of you.
All right.
Because he couldn't
right.
call in.
603 is the only reason you called is to, you know, talk about the disproving of 30-second goldfish memory? Or do you have anything else?
Well, I had to prove my point.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that you're
this
wrong.
This
again,
is 2 inches, by the way.
Okay, so everything that Mythbusters does is true.
Yeah.
Oh.
Hi, 2 inches!
Did your girlfriend enjoy all 2 inches last night for her birthday?
Yeah.
Did she like all of the reasons that, like, why she wrote us the letter?
Yeah, she liked the Mount Gayness a lot.
Why
yeah.
would you not include a picture of your girlfriend
Mal
with the
Gaines.
Letter? It doesn't even make sense.
Yeah.
I mean,
she wrote the letter. I didn't write shit.
I know. Why didn't she include in a picture
anything.
Of herself?
Well, it's tits or GTFO. And she should know that.
Dude, you know what? I was really upset that, oh, you saw we drank the Jaeger, obviously. We made good use
no,
of it.
No, I came into the show late.
What?
Oh.
We had OJJs, bro. We had OJJs. We had fucking orange juice and Jaeger up in this bitch. It looked like two girls, one cup fucking feces. It was pretty nasty. All right, bro. Hey, camera ate that fucking crunch bar faster than you could say crunch. Or
Butterfinger,
whatever.
Way to go, goldfish.
Oh, I forgot one thing out of the million that I remember during the day.
Hey.
What are the three items you need to beat Medusa at the end of Kid Icarus?
Getting laid, vagina, and boobs.
Yeah, okay.
That's the three things
All
you
right.
need to beat.
2 inches. Thanks, dude. We'll see you tomorrow during EG Nights, right, bro?
Oh, yeah.
All right. You better be there, bitch. All right. Peace out. All right. It's time to close the fucking show.
Sheila, girl. Doesn't
wait,
matter. Kid
wait,
Icarus
wait,
sucked.
Wait. I'm taking this call. I'm taking this call, guys. The one. The only Ren Camo in the motherfucking house.
Someone just asked about him the other day on Xbox Live, actually.
Where Ren Camo are
yeah,
you there?
Where's Ren Camo?
Dude.
Hey,
Wheat.
Oh,
the call
hey,
ended.
Hey, Suma. Hey, Wheat. Hey, Suma. Hey, guys. Right. Hey.
The call ended, you guys. Sorry.
Momentaria. I don't know what your problem is. I don't know what janky ass phone you're trying to call in, but nothing's coming up. It's not our fault.
Sorry, dude.
Problem on your end.
Sorry about yeah. that. All right, guys, it's time to close up Face for Radio number 8. I want to wish you all a very happy weekend. But the festivities don't stop tonight. Join us tomorrow for EG Nights. You can visit our webpage. Well, when it's up. Thanks a lot.
We have a guest next week, too.
EpilepticGaming.GGL.com. Join us, and let's play some fucking Warhawk in Rainbow Six Vegas 2 tomorrow. With that being said, Suma, you got any final words there, buddy?
Goldfish are smarter than humans.
All right.
It's been proven.
My final words are all you have to do is listen to that guy over there, and you realize that he's absolutely wrong. That being said, this is DJ Wheat, Suma, and, of course, the Peanut Gallery. We got Camera and Cammy back there. Laughing it up all night long. All right, guys. I'm out of here. Peace.
Bye.
tablets of mescaline, 5 sheets of high-powered blotter acid, a salt shaker half full of cocaine, a whole galaxy of multicolored uppers, downers, screamers, laughers, also a quarter tequila, a quarter rum, a case of beer, a pint of raw ether, 2 dozen ale. Once you get locked into a serious drug collection, not that we needed all that for the trip, the tendency is to push it as far as you can.